Okay, welcome back, everybody. And tonight, of course, it's a great night. I'm very, very honored to stand here at the Schule Alencon University Music Hall with none other than Mr. Wim Mertens. Welcome to the Kingdom of Thailand.
Thank you.
Is it the first time here?
Absolutely. It's my first visit in Bangkok and also Thailand, of course.
Okay. We actually don't have a lot of time because the concert is going to, believe it or not, start within 10 minutes or so. Just a short interview and a few questions. A remarkable, remarkable career and great work. We could talk for hours, I guess, with what you've been doing. But for all our viewers in Thailand, what is the music today for you, and what does it mean nowadays, in 2013?
Well, I think for me it's a special experience to perform my music in a place like Thailand, because actually when I started performing, recording my music in the early 80s, actually in 1980, already I also had to take a different position from what was at that time the popular, so-called popular classical music, which was more linked to what we call the avant-garde music. And I was looking maybe for a kind of music maybe less based on scores and on overdetermination of the notes, but more inspired by vocal elements, singing, and also less determinated in the realization. So looking for what I called much, much later, like an open continuum.
Fantastic. I was able to go through a little bit of your career, and you've done a lot of work, a lot of albums, and a lot of music for movies. What's that today when it comes to all these high-definition documentaries? And has music changed that scene?
Absolutely. Not only on the technical point of view. Literally, my generation went to all the formats of analog, the beginning of the digital. Also in terms of recording, not only in terms of distribution. And it was very important to start in the context of an independent label in the 80s. So already the rules which were imposed on the composers were too narrow, probably. And although you don't have a fixed plan when you start composing music, probably I had felt that I needed a more larger environment in terms of record companies, in terms of audiences also, because these audiences for my music came from very different musical styles. They were less, let's say, well defined, and I hope that this input is going on until today.
Fascinating. Just the last question before I'm gonna let you go. I know there's a lot of people waiting right there in the background. What are we going to expect for tonight? What can we listen for tonight?
Tonight I will play the piano, of course, but also there will be some strategic singing in a lot of pieces. So the idea is to present pieces as well for from the 80s as the 90s. Actually, the oldest pieces are from 82. They always evaluate, and they have to be presented in a new context, also depending on the place where you play. So actually we get like an overview is a great word, but we get sources from more than 30 years of composing.
Well, fantastic. Well, thank you very, very much for stopping by tonight. And we'll see you in a few minutes, I guess.
Thank you very much.
Okay, we're gonna go for a short break. When we come back, well, the concert itself will start and you'll enjoy it as much as we will, I guess. Don't go away. All that when My Second Home with Daniel returns. Don't change that channel.
Thank you.
right, welcome everybody. Tonight we are going to talk about music, and in the best way. I am standing here, I'm so honored. I'm standing next to the ambassador of the Kingdom of Belgium, His Excellency Mr. Mark Mikkelsen. How are you, sir?
I'm fine, thank you.
Well, tonight we are here for a very, very special occasion. Can you tell us a little bit about that?
Well, tonight we have here in Bangkok a solo concert with a Belgian pianist, composer, vocalist called Wim Mertens. He is, I think, from Belgium, the most important contemporary composer. He has recorded more than 50 CDs the last 30 years.
Wow.
And he has toured the world, and today will be his premiere in Bangkok. So I'm quite happy that this can happen today.
Fantastic, fantastic. We were talking a little bit about off camera. This year is a special year. It's the 100. Well, tell all our viewers about it, please.
Well, we are celebrating a double anniversary. 145 years ago, Thailand and Belgium established or signed their first treaty, the Treaty of Friendship. And 130 years ago, we established diplomatic relations. And to celebrate that, I would say, with a certain splendor, we organize couple of activities. I think the most important one is the one that's taking place tonight at the concert of Wim Mertens, which will be really exceptional. And then for the, I would say, the larger public, next week in the Plaza Athenee Hotel, we will have a Belgian food week where the Thai public can discover, I would say, the very good Belgian cuisine, including the Belgian beers.
Fantastic beer. I love those.
Thank you. Yeah, I hope you come.
I definitely will. I definitely will. Well, thank you very much for inviting us. If people need more information about the activities and what the Belgian embassy is organizing right here on the Kingdom of Thailand, you can, of course, log on to this website, their own website, or you can log on to our own website, which is my second home. Thailand.com. Thank you very much, sir, for stopping by.
Thank you very much.
Okay, we're gonna move inside, and we're gonna meet the musician Wim Mertens himself right after break. Please don't change that channel. We'll be right back.